Hi, I'm Carl. This movie is the second in a series that takes a closer look at the features, setup, and programming of Yamaha's iPad app called ProVisionaire Touch. In the first video, we took a look at a few ready-made examples of ProVisionaire Touch, so let's now try designing one from scratch. We open up the app from our screen, and then we can choose to load an existing file or start a new one from scratch. Let's open up a new one by pressing the plus symbol at the top left of the screen and creating a new file. We give it a name, I'll call it Restaurant, and then I'll choose a blank template and hit Done. At some point, you'll need to create some access codes, but for the sake of speed, we'll ignore that at the moment. Now we're ready to start designing. In the top middle of the screen is the operation mode. It's here we switch between design mode, which is where we want to be, and control mode, which you activate to go live with your design. Now, ensuring that you're in design mode, we now want to choose a background for our controller. A little design tip for making a background for ProVisionaire Touch is that the landscape resolution for the latest iPad versions is 2048 by 1536 pixels. And if you're designing using a graphics package such as Photoshop, then set your image to be this size and it will fit perfectly onto the ProVisionaire Touch screen. I tend to pre-arrange my graphics for designing in ProVisionaire Touch beforehand, as it makes the whole process a lot easier. To choose our background, we click Page Edit. This is where we can scroll through the available widgets, but for now, we want to choose Background and then flick on the Image switch. Click on Select Image and Photos. Now, I've already prepared one for my restaurant, so I'll simply touch it and it appears as my background. Providing you've scaled it correctly in your graphics package, then you can simply choose Full in the expansion mode. Experiment more with these modes when you get a chance. Next, I want to create the four faders that will control my inputs. Clicking again on the widget tab, I can now swipe through until I get to the faders. I'll choose the one on the right and you'll see it appear on the main screen. Let's stick with one fader for now. We tap the screen outside that box and you're left with the fader in edit mode on the screen. I can drag it or any widget around the screen with my finger. Tapping it again will pop up a menu of adjustments. These include copy, design, arrange, parameter, fixed size, and delete. To start with, we can click Design, which opens up the scaling grid. Click the screen to close the other options and drag the corner guides to select your desired size. Back in Design, we can adjust other features such as color. There are preset colors, or I can use the RGB and alpha controls. I can add gradient to the design, as well as many other features. You can also choose from a range of fader knobs and adjust the guidelines. When you're happy, click the screen and click the fader again. This time, I'm going to hit copy. Once copied, I can click anywhere on the screen and hit paste to duplicate my fader. Now, I have four identical faders. There's also a useful multi-select tool at the top of the page, which lets you edit more than one widget simultaneously. The little yellow paperclip icon next to each fader means that I have yet to associate any parameter with this fader or widget, but we'll see how to do that in a separate movie guide. Next, we should label each fader. A nice way to do that is to choose a rectangle widget via Page Edit. While in design mode, you can turn the alpha control down to zero for the body color and keep the border switched off. This will turn the button transparent. Now you have a transparent box within which to type. To enter text, you simply double tap on the widget and away you go. To change font type and color, etc., choose text from the list of edit options. It's easy. In the next movie, we'll see how to assign parameters to your widgets from a remote control setup list for MRX or from the ready-made list for MTX. Thanks for watching.